Why is not any one parameter good enough to demonstrate the growth throughout the life of a flowering plant? So students, now let us understand why one parameter is not sufficient to demonstrate growth in a flowering plant. So generally in plants, the growth is said to have taken place when the amount of protoplasm increases. So we say growth occurs in the plant cells when the protoplasm increases. For example, you can see here. So this is a cell, nucleus, vacuole and the protoplasm. So this is surrounded by the cell membrane and cell wall. Now if you compare these two cells, so this is a cell which has undergone growth. So here the volume of the cell has increased, the size of the cell has increased, the protoplasm content has been increased. And generally growth is defined as, so if there is increase in the amount of the protoplasm, so protoplasm includes the nucleus and the cytoplasm. So if the nucleus and the cytoplasm content, if it has been increased, we say growth has taken place. So measuring growth of a protoplasm involves to measure the growth of the protoplasm. It is not easy to define that, to measure the growth of protoplasm. So it involves many parameters. So one is the weight of the fresh tissue sample, weight of the dry tissue sample, difference in the length, area, volume, cell number, which is measured during the growth period. So these are the parameters. So one, that is length, volume, area, weight of the fresh sample, and then you have to dry it and weigh the dry tissue, and the number of cells, how many cells are present during the growth period. So these are the parameters which gives the final conclusion that if growth in the protoplasm has occurred or not. So measuring the growth of plants using only one parameter does not provide enough information, and hence it is insufficient for demonstrating growth. Now many parameters are there, so with one parameter we cannot conclude that growth has taken place or not. So that is why the questions ask, why is not any one parameter good enough to demonstrate growth? So there are many parameters which is required to determine whether growth has taken place or not. So by measuring all these parameters, we can come to a conclusion that growth has taken place.